Hey, space fans, welcome back to the Lut Crasimi system, where things are about to get pretty wild. We're kicking off dwarf planet season here in solar system 2.0, and I can't wait to dive in and show you around. But before we meet the newest addition, let's do a quick recap on who's who in this system. Because trust me, each planet has a story that's way more than meets the eye. All right, let's start with the big shots. Lut, our fierce blue giant, and his partner, Crasimi, the calm red dwarf. Together, these two are like the system's gravity anchors, keeping everything in line. But it's not just gravity they bring. They're also setting the vibe for all the planets nearby. Lut's hot and intense, while Crasimi's more chill, making a mix of different climates throughout the system. Then there's Ticed, a planet with split personality disorder. One side's always facing Lut, getting scorched, and the other side's freezing in permanent darkness. It's a harsh place for sure, but also kind of awesome. Ticed is like a constant reminder of the crazy push and pull that happens in a double star setup. Now let's look at Aesphaltor, the blessed world. This one's thriving, with oceans, alien life, and plenty of green. Aesphaltor found the perfect spot between Lut and Crasimi, right in the Goldilocks zone, where everything is just right. And here's a fun fact. Its magnetic field is almost identical to Earth's. Coincidence? Maybe, but I like to think it shows life will find a way, even in a place like this. Now, Sodicras, well, this is one you'd want to appreciate from a safe distance. It's got thick, acidic clouds and skies that look more sulfuric than serene. But hey, every system needs a troublemaker, right? Now here's Frohe, a gas giant that practically embodies holiday cheer. Instead of colorful rings, Froa's entire surface is wrapped in vibrant red and green bands, almost like a cosmic Christmas ornament. These colors make it stand out against the darkness, as if Froa's throwing a year-round celebration for anyone who stops by. Those festive bands aren't just for show. They likely point to different gases in its atmosphere, adding to the planet's lively look. Then there's Benezuel, a custom-made wonder built from scratch in God Edit mode. It's a mix of Mars and Venus, with a hazy atmosphere and deep red rivers. It's not the most welcoming place, but it's definitely one of the most dramatic looking. The color? That comes from iron, sulfur dioxide, and a few other exotic elements that make it look like something straight out of a sci-fi novel. Now, Klovid is a different story. Imagine a gas giant, but with a ghostly gray look, kind of like it's been drained of color. Some say it used to be vibrant like the others, but something big happened. Maybe a collision, maybe intense radiation, and now Klovid's left with this quiet, haunted vibe. Looking at it feels like peering into the past, like a cosmic time capsule. Next up, we've got the latest addition, Maximus. Now this one's a bit special. It's not a natural planet at all. Maximus was designed by some advanced alien civilization, specifically to monitor young solar systems like ours. Its X-shaped rings aren't just for show, they're spy satellites, an advanced tech network set up to observe the system. Maximus itself has these dark blue to lighter blue bands, with a striking white and black pole that gives it an eye-like appearance, almost as if it's blinking at us from across space. With Maximus here, it feels like we're being watched, maybe even judged. And finally, meet Plexia. This one's an outsider that got pulled into the Lut Crasimi system, kind of like the cool cousin from out of town. With its colorful rings and tilted orbit, Plexia is here to stand out. Each ring tells a story of its journey across the galaxy, so it's like a scrapbook of all the chaos it's been through. But that's enough of the recap. Today's real star is a brand new visitor, Orthon. Orthon might look like just another dwarf planet, but it's got some surprises up its sleeve. It's slightly smaller than Pluto, but has a history that's pretty wild. Orthon's story starts way out in the depths of space, far from any stars. It was just a lonely, frozen rock floating along. But over millions of years, it started picking up debris, little by little. Some people think these bits came from a nearby planetary collision. Others think it's leftovers from an ancient supernova. Whatever the case, Orthon started collecting these cool organic compounds called tholins. And that's where things get interesting. These yellow tholins didn't just show up out of nowhere. They were built up by radiation in deep space. Over time, Orthon developed this unique teal and yellow look. Think of it like a cosmic tattoo, a reminder of everything it's been through. And that's not all. Orthon kept collecting material until a full ring system formed. These rings stretch from 2.3 to 5.1 radii, like a halo that holds bits of rock, ice, and dust. Orthon picked up along its journey, kind of personal memory album. As it got closer to Lut Crasimi, Orthon was just a faint teal glow on the edge of the system. But now with its arrival, it could actually shake things up. Its rings alone could create some new gravitational effects, and maybe even pull in a few asteroids. Orthon could change everything. Its arrival might stir things up in ways we can't even predict. But what makes Orthon really exciting isn't just the journey or the rings. It's the mystery of what's underneath those tholins. Could it hold clues to other dwarf planets, or even some new form of life? There's even a chance those rings might not be as stable as they look. Lut and Crasimi's pull could start shifting them. Something tells me Orthon has a few surprises in store. So there you have it. Orthon, the cosmic wanderer. A dwarf planet with a story of resilience and a style that's all its own. I'm excited to see how it stirs things up in this system. Could it unlock new mysteries or cause a little chaos? Only time will tell. If you're as curious as I am, make sure to stick around, subscribe, and hit that like button for more adventures in Solar System 2.0. And hey, drop a comment below. What do you think Orthon's rings are hiding? Until next time, keep exploring, space travelers.